Good morning, Staples.
It's Tuesday, March 27th.
I'm Hannah Foley.
And I'm Sam Gasway.
Mr. Dodick will appear on our show twice today.
First, with a piece of good news, and later in the show, with more important information about something we'll be doing at school this Thursday.
So first, let's welcome our principal with some accolades.
Kudos to all in Staples players. I have to be honest in saying that I saw the original Broadway production of Into the Woods and thought it was boring. Whatever Mr. Roth did to tweak the show certainly worked. I thoroughly enjoyed every part of the show. Let's check out some highlights.
Once upon a time.
Of her own.
Look at your nails, look at your dress.
People would laugh at you.
Nevertheless, she still wants to go to the festival and dance before the prince.
You foolish child! What in heaven's name were you doing with a cow inside the house?
The warm environment might be just what Milky White needs to produce his milk.
Into the woods to bring some bread to Granny, who was sick in bed. Never can tell what lies ahead. For all that I know, she's already dead.
Greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, pepper, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and fiddle ferns, and lettuce, he said, all right.
When first I appear, I seem mysterious. But when explained, I'm nothing serious.
Agony! Oh, the torture they teach!
What big eyes you have!
The better to see you with, my dear.
But even one prick, it's my thing about blood.
Well, it's sick.
It smells sicker than your thing with dwarves.
Dwarves!
Dwarves,
dwarves are very upsetting.
Into the woods you have to grow, but that's the way you learn to grow.
Congratulations to all the cast members, our set designer, the tech crew that built the beautiful set, moved the pieces, and lit the show. Also, a big shout-out to Mrs. Valovich and all members of the Pitt Orchestra. The music was fantastic. This is the production of Into the Woods that I will now remember fondly. I'll be back in a few minutes to talk to you about this Thursday. But for now, I'd like to send it back to the host.
Thanks, Mr. Dodig. You're all involved in thinking about and signing up for classes for the next year. We'd like to do a few features on some of those classes here at Staples.
Both long-established ones and some that will be brand new next year. First up, Beatrice and Lisa put together a piece about our child development classes.
Hi, my name is Nina. This is my brother, Jesse. And Jesse is 4.
Kids, usually, they come in, the parent will drop them off. They proceed to go and take off their coats and their mittens or whatever they're wearing, and they put it on the rack, and then they will go and wash their hands.
But I wash my hands because they see my hands are dirty. We go outside, we wash our hands, and then we eat snack.
What do you usually eat for snack?
Goldfish.
What do you play with at play school, Ethan?
Monster truck. As line of the tag of Ethan.
I've definitely made special connections with some of the kids. One in particular definitely I've had a very close connection with because I am his big buddy.
Really get to learn about the children as they learn about you, so that's really great.
Name of one of the student teachers and tell me something she taught you.
Yeah. Thank you. She always has flowers in her hair.
They don't have flowers. On the teacher's on the road.
On the road? Where? The parking lot?
Not a parking lot. On the down.
I
would recommend taking this class because it's a great experience working with kids, and if that's a field you're interested in, then this is a perfect place.
A couple weeks ago, there was a new face behind the desk in our library media center.
A new face for Staples, who is an old friend to half the school that went to Coleytown Middle School.
Alex, Giles, and Andrew did this interview as a way of officially welcoming Mrs. Horrigan to this side of North Avenue.
I'm here with the new librarian, Mrs. Horrigan.
Hi, my name is Betty Horrigan. I used to work at Coleytown Middle School Library.
How are you liking Staples?
Great. I'm so happy to see my former students and also kids from BMS, and they're very polite and nice and giving me big smiles every day.
Do you miss the middle school?
Yes, of course. I love those little kids. I still see them when I went to grocery shopping. They're just all over me. They're great kids.
What's your favorite part about Staples?
Well, I spend most of my time in the library just helping the students. They're very busy.
What do you do in your free time?
Dancing and listening to the music.
What's your favorite book?
Hunger Games.
Have you seen The Hunger Games yet?
Tomorrow, after school.
Well, you heard it here, Staples. Mrs. Horrigan.
Welcome, Mrs. Horrigan. As the weather gets warmer, we'll be spending more and more time outside.
There are a couple of events happening at Sherwood Island over the next couple of weeks that we want to let you know about.
First of all, this Sunday, there is a 5 and 10K run, followed by a 1.5-mile and 3-mile walk, to try and win the battle against Lyme's disease.
Hey Staples, I'm Andrew Travers, and this weekend there is a run/walk at Sherwood Island. You can register from now until Friday online. The run is meant to bring awareness to Lyme's disease, so here's Staples runner Reed Geisler to tell you about the disease.
Hi, I'm Reed Geisler. I got second in the Lyme Sherwood walk run last year. In October, I'd say, I was starting to get very tired. I could hardly do my work from school, and coming back from cross-country practice each day, I would just completely wipe out. I'd just fall asleep on the couch, wake up around 7 or so, eat dinner, then do my work, and go to sleep again. I continued for about a month or two until I got so bad to the point where I was worrying that it might be a serious illness. So I decided to go see the doctor, and he just thought I was generally not getting enough sleep because of my sleep patterns were very irregular. But I still insisted on getting a blood test, and the results came back that Lyme disease is positive. That was about in December. And then I started taking treatments, and within a week or two, I was feeling great, back to my normal self.
Hopefully we'll see some of you guys there. Back to the hosts.
Also, on April 14th, Best Buddies is having their annual friendship walk at Sherwood Island.
Mike tracked down Patty for some more information and has some highlights of last year's walk. Here's his report.
Hey. Patty at the front desk had to tell me something about Best Buddies. Best Buddies is having a walk this April, and she told me all about it. Here's what she told me.
Hi, I'm Patty, and I'm here to just mention a few things about Best Buddies that we're doing. What I want to mention is that we're doing a walk on April 14th. April 14th, I have information here at the front desk, and it's to benefit the Best Buddies Connecticut, statewide. Be selling a foot. So you can buy a foot for $1 during the lunch periods next week. I'm not exactly sure which days right now, but You know what? It's going to be Wednesday, the 7th, during the lunch period. You can buy a foot for a dollar, and then you get some candy to go along with this. You put your name on the middle of the foot, and then we will be putting them around on the bulletin boards to show that you yourself donated a dollar towards the Best Buddies Friendship Walk. So don't forget to buy your foot. You can buy two if you want. And donate a dollar and help Best Buddies with their friendship walk.
Best Buddies Walk is this April. And that's all I have to say. And back to the host.
On last Thursday's show, the student group Cool to Be Kind had a video that invited you to join their group. That deadline has been extended. Here they are to tell you about it.
Hey guys, we've gotten so many applications, so we've moved the deadline to next Thursday. You can pick up your applications in Chris Simone's office or at the library, and it's really fun, so make sure you apply.
Well, tryouts are done and over, and our sports teams will soon be in action. That will mean we'll be able to bring you highlights of the action on Good Morning Staples.
We get many of those highlights from Staples television broadcasts. STN is busy preparing for their spring broadcast with the hopes of broadcasting baseball, lacrosse, rugby, volleyball, and tennis.
There is the need for more people to work behind the scenes and also to do play-by-play. As you watch these next few clips, realize there had to be students on the cameras, doing the graphics, as well as calling the action.
Outside, he picks up the first down and more. Matt Kelly down the sideline, one man to beat, makes a miss, still on his feet. Matt Kelly to the 15, 10, 5, touchdown Staples!
Yard line, a 33-yard field goal. Here's the snap, King of Hart! The Staples Wreckers are going to the state playoffs!
Finds Rankowitz, corner three try. Three ball, corner pocket, Brendan Rankowitz.
Stolen by the Wreckers, Jaeger heads to Rankowitz, up and in!
Sean Gallagher, Danbury Riders,
who wins? The
it's Sean Gallagher, champion. In the end!
Long shot, try, scores! That's Brandon Wader, and he gets it to go with just 2 seconds remaining here in the third.
If you'd like to take part in helping STN to cover our spring sports, come to the meeting after school this Thursday.
Now, here's Mr. Dodig once again with some important instructions.
Thanks. When the unthinkable happened at Chardon High School in Chardon, Ohio, on February 27th of this year, the students, faculty, and local law enforcement were ready. Teachers knew what to do, too, locking down students in the safe rooms while an assistant football coach chased the gunman from the school. In order to increase our preparedness for a situation like this, on this Thursday, we will conduct a lockdown drill. We will conduct this 10-minute drill during the middle of period 4, from roughly 10:15 to 10:20. The full plan has been distributed by email to all Staples staff so that they can be prepared to carry out their responsibilities on Thursday the 29th. While our plan is fairly comprehensive, an important thing to remember is that each of the areas for refuge stated in the plan exists under perfect situations. No plan or amount of rehearsal could have prepared the students of Chardon High School for how to actually react on the morning of February 27th. Faced with a classmate turned gunman in the cafeteria, nearby students knew what to do from emergency drills. Remembering that their ultimate goal was to seek safe refuge, they fled to the teacher's lounge, barricading the door with a piano without any staff instructions. Certain situations requiring the school to go into lockdown mode will require quick thinking, reaction, and initiative on the part of both students and staff, depending on conditions which may be fluid and changing. Many scenarios requiring a lockdown are chaotic and unpredictable and will require calm and deliberate action that no drill can totally prepare for. The ultimate goal during a lockdown is to have all members of the school community in as secure an area as possible to mitigate the risks. If an actual lockdown were to ever occur at Staples, your ultimate goal, if you are isolated, is to find as secure a place as possible out of sight of any intruder. If you arrive at the building during this time, the front door will be locked. Do not panic, it's just for the drill. Naturally, if you have any questions or concerns, please speak to me or to one of your assistant principals. Thanks.
Thanks, Mr. Dodig. And don't forget about that lockdown on period 4 on Thursday.
That's our show for the day.
The Period 2 class will be back here on Thursday. Bye.
Bye.